Today, here's Jason Pett, who just got that goal back behind the net, marked there by Jay Robbins. Pett back up top for Pasquale. Mark Pasquale working on Sokolowski, left side. In front for Kearney, shot, score! Tim Kearney has tied it up, 6-6. Kearney off the feed in front, Pasquale making it happen on the move. And the Irish have gotten things tied up 1 minute and 3 seconds into the third quarter. All the momentum is now gone, Pat.
Yeah, it just looked like Kearney just walked in. Lopresti didn't even seem to move on that one, Anthony. He just beat him low, almost like hit the post in there, just shielded, flew it right by him.
Yeah, may have been screened in front by his own defenseman. There you see the UMass defenseman, it was Jared Lanning, not too pleased by that play. So 1 minute, 3 seconds in, Tim Kearney has tied things up.
From Pasquale there, they gave Pasquale the assist on that one. You know, UMass has just got to settle down right now, try to win a few faceoffs and get the ball back into the offensive zone.
And Robbins and Kelly combined to win this faceoff. Dennis Kelly comes sweeping in on it. He'll make the run down the right side with his long stick. Gives it up for Valente now.
Ioria all over him still since the beginning of the game, Anthony.
Interesting matchup there by Kevin Corrigan. Let's put him on UMass's playmaker instead of the big goal scorers. Left side, here's Buddy Hoffman. Hoffman guarded by Bialis. Del Percio running behind the goal. Sutton will mark him. Notre Dame has come out strong here with two quick goals to start the third quarter. Del Percio, tight cut from around behind the goal. Double team, can't get a pass or a shot off, and they'll feed it back up now for Eric Bailey.
Yeah, Notre Dame wanted a penalty there, the pushing off foul with the odd hand.
We saw that one called before on Notre Dame's Willie Sutton. Back behind the goal, shot goes wide. Valente, the first man on it, does not reach the sidelines, and he'll keep it in for UMass.
Yeah, we need Mike Valente to step it up right now, start feeding the ball like he's been doing recently. Iorio is really shutting him down all day today.
And there we see that matchup isolated behind the goal. Iorio on Valente. Iorio's got a lot of height and pounds on him there, but he spins away, centers one shot. Stanziali's shot never gets through. And a good move there by Valente, goes for naught. Here's Brendan Glass back up now for Eric Bailey, right side. Up top now, it's Del Percio. Del Percio moving right side as the sun has gone in. A bit of an overcast weather here for second half. Wouldn't be surprised to see the chance of showers predicted to come through here. To the front of that, Del Percio falls. He's on the ground. Back the other way comes Notre Dame. And the Irish on the counterattack. Chris Berry on the hit. Sutton, right side for Bialis. He loses the handle to the corner. Gil Fillon gives chase there. And the Irish will maintain possession.
Yeah, the one who made that all happen was Todd Bialis right there for Notre Dame. He just knocked the ball right out of the stick of the UMass player.
And here's Sutton on it, left side for the Irish. Takes a high shot, goes well wide of the crossbar. But Gil Fillon in the corner, and he'll be the first one to the sidelines. Notre Dame ball all tied at six here. UMass struggling to get things going offensively.
Yeah, still momentum swing for Notre Dame right now. They just have been controlling this whole second, third
Here's
period.
Gil Fillon. Grounder goes just wide of the post. A very interesting move there by Brian Gil Fillon. Sort of let one go right on the ground and tried to hope it would skip through. And just got by Lopresti, but wide of the post.
Almost a kick save right there by Lopresti.
And here's Randy Colley back behind the goal for the Irish. There now is Tim Kearney. As we mentioned, Notre Dame will need to find some secondary scoring. They've gotten it here from Kearney and Pett in the second half to tie things up at six. Here's Kearney again, back behind the goal. Colley. And he's top gun jump shot, just goes wide. He was at an on angle. Lopresti will fight for the rebound. Now almost kicks out in front. That would have been real dangerous, but Lopresti's on it for the Minuteman.
Yeah, nice play by Lopresti, although he just threw the ball away.
Tough pass ahead for Bailey and Glass. Glass can keep it in, so we'll go right back to Notre Dame. UMass not playing a crisp game with the passes here in the second half.
No, not at all. Lopresti seemed to get a little panicked there. He wanted to get the ball out of the zone, so he just threw it up. Unfortunately, it did amount to a turnover.
So at midfield, Notre Dame will come back the other way. And here's Jason Pett. He'll swing it all though, get over the left wing. With JT Tremonte standing on a bounds line, as we'll go back to the Minuteman end.
Yeah, possibly an offsides there. Just another turnover for UMass they've got to capitalize on.
And Pat, we have not seen the return of UMass's second leading scorer, Jeremy Murphy, out with a strained left hamstring. One of the big keys of the second half is who will step up in Murphy's place and do some scoring for Coach Canella's squad.
Yeah, you got to look at guys like the other midfielders, you know, Costello and Grande, just really step it up for the Minutemen.
And here's the one shining star, Brendan Glass. He's got four goals here There's a back four. Casey Costello up top now for Chris Grande. Grande holds, gives it for Costello. Left side UMass making some changes. Eric Triolo now will come on. Costello on the move. Look in the swing. He's got right side Grande. Beats his man off the move. Pass down low for Triolo. Couldn't get it there. Now he'll get it back for Chris Grande. Grande gets it back to Costello. Teams are tied at six. UMass looking to stop this Notre Dame momentum. Had a two-goal lead at halftime, and ND has come out strong here in the third quarter. Here's Triolo working the baseline. Trying to cut to the center. In the slot area, he's got two men on his back. Gets it back up for Grande. Grande looking for Costello. Gets to him off his stick, though. Tough pass right in front. And stolen away, James Keenan. He'll stop and bring it back the other way for Notre Dame through the timeline. His pass off his teammate, and stepping the way is Gil Fillon, and he's got it there for the Irish. Up for Pete Snyder. And that will go to the corner there. On it is Kearney. Kearney's got to step in front. Gets it back. Indy will take their time now. Bialas on it.
Nice control right there by Keenan bringing the ball up. Got about four checks and did not lose the ball once, Anthony.
Gil Fillon back behind the goal. Gets it up top now. Tremonte. Indy will work it around. Take their time. Maroney on it left side. Here's Colley. Colley marked by Deliacono. Gets it up for Tremonte. Low shot goes just wide. Gil Fillon is there. And it will remain Irish ball.
A flag down on the play as we wait for the call. Possibly on UMass here.
That's the call will indeed be on the Minutemen. We'll see who heads to the box. This will be the first extra man opportunity for the Irish.
Yeah, the first period, UMass 1-for-2 on the EMO, and Notre Dame did not face did not have an EMO, so they were 0-for-0.
And now they will. Vin Deliacono in the box for the Minutemen. We'll wait to get the official call. Back to live action. It's a 1-minute penalty on Vin Deliacono. Up top, here come the Irish. Mahoney gets it low right side. Gil Fillon back up now for Hayes. Down low, right in front, shot scores. Sutton set up. Great feed from Kevin Mahoney. Willie Sutton, his second goal of the game. The Irish have regained the lead 7-6.
Yeah, I was waiting for Sutton to make some big moves. He is the lesser known man, but also one of the big guns for this Notre Dame team. As right there, he just pretty much was in front of the net, just took the shot on the EMO.
Extra man opportunity. He was the extra man right there, all alone in front for Sutton. His 18th goal of the season. And the Irish now have the lead. Three straight goals here in the third quarter for Notre Dame.
Yeah, as we take a look at it right here, as Mahoney just feeds him in perfectly. Sutton wide open on the road, beat Lopresti. Lopresti had to jump to the other side of the net, just could not catch up.
You can't ask for a better placed pass than that and be more wide open than Willie Sutton was, but he gets the goal and the assist to Kevin Mahoney. Here's Kelly through midfield. UMass cannot handle it. Now they jump on it. Robbins can't handle it. Blast there. Notre Dame will tip it up to midfield. McDonald on the steal by the Minutemen. UMass needs some offensive possession right now.
Yeah, it's been all Notre Dame as of thus far. Three goals in the second half here.
Here's Kelly up for Robbins. UMass on the move in transition. Back for Glass. He spins around his man to the front of the net. Loses the handle. Now it's still loose in front, and Notre Dame will come away with it, though. Todd Rassis, he's tackled in the corner. UMass steals it from him there. Henry Stanziali on it.
And a nice play on that last one by Burry, the defensive player on Glass. As Glass beat him by, Dury still got the stick in and knocked the ball away.
Here's Jay Robbins on it. He'll change off now. Bunny Hoffman on. Eric Bailey joins as well. Mike Del Percio steps on for the Minutemen as they all get some offensive players out there. UMass is down one here midway through the third quarter. On the move, Bailey, he'll lose the handle. And it is knocked away. Todd Rassis on it for the Irish, and they'll get it up. There's Iorio on it, big number 35, All-American. Gets it up right side now for Jason Pett. Back behind the goal. Gil Fillon for Colley. Colley marked there by Lanning. Trying to get things in front. Now they would be content to take the slowdown offensive approach. Pasquale on the move, beats one man. His pass goes wide, not sure who that was intended for, but he had a step on his man to the front of the goal, it appeared.
Yeah, and another thing to look at on the sideline for UMass right now, Vinny Delicano is on the sideline. Looked like after he took that penalty, he was down on his hands and knees, maybe gasping for breath, needs a breather. And that's huge for Notre Dame because Colley's going to have a different man on him. Looks like Jared Lanning right now, and Lanning's been known to be beat this season.
Here's Sutton guarded by McDonald. Sutton up top, swings it right side, back behind the goal now. It's Colley, wraparound shot, saved by Lopresti. Great stop there by Tom Lopresti.
Yeah, beautiful save right there on pretty much an open shot as Colley used the net as a pick right there. Beat landing, just like I talked about, they need to get Vin Delicano back in the game.
That was a great move that time by Colley. Up front, Del Percio can't handle the pass. Notre Dame, yet another steal. Billy Gallagher, one of the tri-captains, back through midfield, gets it on Kearney's stick. And Notre Dame now in transition, 3-on-3, limited in front of the net here. Here's Gilfillan, finds a man cutting. It's Colley. He's checked twice, loses the handle. Excuse me, that was Pasquale, number one. And we'll get a call here, no doubt a pushing call on the Minuteman. Coach, assistant coach Jim Strube on the sidelines, his arms extended as you see on the screen there. Not pleased with that call at all.
As we take a look at the last call right here, as Pasquale was just hammered. Was just hammered right there. It looks like Harold Drum got a piece of him. And the penalty will be on as we take a look on New Mass.
Brendan Glass sitting in the penalty box. He came from behind as well to get a piece of 1 minute penalty on Glass. EMO, second opportunity for Notre Dame. A shot there by Colley, another stop by Tom Lopresti. He's raising his play here in the third quarter when the Minutemen have needed it most.
Yeah, he's doing real well right now. In the first half, he had 5 out of 9 saves. And right now he's made 2 beautiful saves.
A tough play right there. UMass was in the point of throwing the ball away, but called timeout, got a lucky call there as the ball was going to go out of bounds to Notre Dame. Good break that time for Coach Canella and company. So we've got 5 minutes, 59 seconds remaining here, third quarter. 7-6 lead for the Irish, as we see there, huddle there. Kevin Corrigan knows his team needs to take advantage of this second EMO possibility they've had here in the game. They scored on the first one, and they've got some lethal scores to do the job in front. Now you see Coach Canella on the sidelines talking to his squad. A defensive stop imperative right now.
Yeah, exactly. As we've talked about, you Notre Dame coming with 3 goals this period alone. Coach Canella's really got to tell his troops to step up. You got to, you know, Lopresti's made 2 nice saves thus far in this half. You just got to keep with the momentum, Anthony. You got to take the momentum back at this point if you're UMass.
UMass had that 6-4 lead coming out of the half. Notre Dame has responded with 3 goals here in the quarter. UMass has been held scoreless. Not really many solid offensive opportunities. UMass now in the process of killing off their second penalty as Notre Dame was to score on the first one. Brendan Glass now in the penalty box.
Yeah, a lot of turnovers by both teams early. As you see, Glass nailed the UMass player trying to come up the field. That'd be Billy Gallagher, one of the co-captains, the defensive co-captain for the Irish. As we take a look at the crowd right now, you know, that's what they need. They really need to step it up right now, both teams, that is, if they want to continue on the track that they're on.
So Brendan Glass, a 1 minute penalty. Got about 40 seconds left on that one. Perhaps less at this point. We'll get the official word in a moment.
Yeah, but through 9 minutes of this third period, UMass yet to score. Even as we said, put on a quality shot on net.
Yeah, not much of a challenge put on Alex Cade as of yet. Glass in the box, EMO right now for Notre Dame, but it will be UMass ball deep in their own end. And on it there is Jay Robbins in the corner. Gets it up for Tom Lopresti back behind the goal. Swings it up for Harold Drum, freshman defenseman, left wing. Tries to get it through midfield on Valente. Stick can't handle the pass. And back to the way Gilfillan will chip it up. Notre Dame has it. It's Tim Kearney, right side. He'll lose the handle. Gilfillan now is on it. Spins away from one man. Fans on a pass. Some sloppy play here. McDonald on the steal. He'll get it up. Try to get it through midfield. Has it sticked away.
Anthony, just doesn't seem like anybody wants the ball right now.
3 consecutive turnovers here. Now McDonald's slow to get to his feet. The referees will stop play. We'll see if Greg McDonald is okay. Limping a bit on his leg there.
Yeah, exactly. As we wait for the official call on that one, he'll have to come out right now.
Yeah, the official did stop play. He'll have to come out. Vin Deliacono will step back on. Greg McDonald will take a seat.
As we take a look at it right here, both teams just slapping for the ball and nobody really wanting it. Looks like he just turned an ankle maybe, rolled over on the offensive player's foot.
He also may have caught a stick there back behind the net. Notre Dame still working on the extra man advantage. Sutton for Kearney, shot, score, Tim Kearney. And Notre Dame has a 2-goal lead using that EMO to perfection. They're now 2-for-2 with an extra man on.
Yeah, and they've also got 4 straight goals in this second half, Anthony. UMass still yet to get on the scoreboard this second half.
So credit Tim Kearney the goal. It's 8-6 now. Notre Dame, UMass has got to stay out of the penalty box. ND has exhibited quite the power play. Tim Kearney gets the goal. his 11th on the, excuse me, his 12th on the season. And Willie Sutton gets his third assist of the game. He's got 16 of those on the year.
Yeah, exactly. Kearney's second goal in the third period alone.
So Kearney gets the goal. Glenn Day and Robbins scrap for the faceoff. Dennis Kelly now jumps in there for the Minutemen. And Glenn Day will peel away from it. ND hammered down there by Robbins. Glenn Day loses it. Johnson to the end. It will be UMass ball. Last touch by Chris Burry.
Yeah, the Notre Dame fans wanted a foul on that one, but it looked like Glenn Day just fell down and didn't need any assist on hitting the ground, Anthony.
So Chris Grande on it for the Minutemen. There you see Jay Robbins. He had a great hit on Greg Glenn Day to force that turnover. Here's Grande moving on it with the Minutemen. Swings it right side for Casey Costell. UMass missing Jeremy Murphy. If he joined this late, UMass's second leading goal scorer out with a strained left hamstring. And now here's Eric Triolo on it for UMass. Up for Brendan Glass now. Glass on the move across the restraining line. Low shot there by Grande. Hits the outside of the post as Cade had his foot there. Now it's Valenti behind that. He'll trigger in for the Minutemen. Good try, though, by Grande. UMass hasn't had many shots at the goal this
quarter. No, that's what they need. They just need people to start firing off quality shots.
There's Triolo. He can't handle the pass. He'll go to the right sideline and scoop it up there. Mike Valenti with a good feed. Triolo just couldn't finish. Here's Triolo back behind the goal now. Making the run, Rassis on him. Rassis falls down, Triolo to the front of the net. He trips as well, can't get a shot off too hard. And Cade stops down when Eric Triolo had the path of the goal wide open, just couldn't stay on his feet.
Yeah, it was a beautiful play right there as he tried to come from behind and scoop it in. You almost looked like he had him beat, but the ball seemed to bounce right underneath Cade's feet and he just scooped it right up.
Through midfield, Michael Maroney on it for the Irish. Maroney back behind the goal now for Gil Fillon. Gets it up for Tremonte. Tremonte up top now, left side for Todd Bialis. Now there's Randy Collin one more time. Back on it is Maroney. And he does some switching, gets some more offensive players out there. Burke Hayes 37 on. He gets a pass, shot, save, low Prestes. He stopped Hayes from point blank range off a great pass.
Exactly, Hayes racing in, trying to beat Casey Costello back into the game, his defensive counterpart, and he gets a nice feed and a nice shot off.
And here's Tremonte working left side back behind the goal for Colley. He'll swing it there into the corner. Gil Fillon guarded by Drum, trying to move in front behind the goal for Colley. Guarded there by Deliacono. Trying to post up on him as Colley. He'll swing it behind the net for Tim Kearney now. They'll move it around for Maroney. Up for Tremonte. He'll try to pull the trigger. Grande is on him. Now it's Kearney. Guarded by Kelly. Notre Dame very patient on the offense.
Yeah, right now they are taking the slow, methodical way.
There's a shot that never gets through. Kelly on the steal. Back the other way. Here comes Eric Triolo. He's in full run. Right side. Feed for Glass. Back to Triolo. Down low pass. Blocked away. Glass can't pick it up. Had a chance for it right in front. Now Triolo on the loose ball. He'll shoot. Goes just wide. Eric Triolo, a good effort. Notre Dame will touch it up there. And it will be ND ball. You can hear the Irish fans now applauding the efforts of goaltender Alex Cade and company.
Yeah, exactly. It's right there. We took a look at it. Eric Triolo made a beautiful, you know, they had the numbers. They had the 4-on-3 advantage. They made a couple nice passes. Maybe one too many. Maybe Glass should have let one drop off from there.
So we've got 2.5 minutes left here, third quarter. UMass still yet to score in the second half. It's 8-6 Notre Dame. It was 6-4 Minutemen at the start of the third. Here's Pett left side. He'll get it for Gil Fillon. Marked there by Drum up top. Notre Dame resets things with Mark Pasquale. Moves around his man. Pasquale hit from behind, loses it, and stolen away. Harold Drum has it on the ground, scoops it up through center for Brendan Glass.
Beautiful hit right there by Jim Kennedy to knock that ball away and turn it over, get the UMass turnover.
Here's Glass turning it to the corner. Goes around his man, Brendan Glass, to the front of the net, shoots and scores. High shot and a goal by Brendan Glass. Great play that time, individual effort. Brendan Glass, his fifth goal of the game, his third straight game when he's tallied 5.
Yeah, 3 of the last 4 games with 5 goals there, Anthony, after the UNH and Harvard games. Glass just blew by his defender right there, Chris Bury, who's been defending him all game. You can't give Brendan Glass a point-blank shot like that and expect him to miss. He just walked right in, beat Cade up top, nobody could stop that.
And you're not going to stop Brendan Glass when he's alone in front, unassisted for Brendan Glass. His 28th on the season, 5th of the day, 1st of the second half for the Minutemen. They've drawn to within one. It's 8-7 Notre Dame. Robbins, an important faceoff right now for the Minutemen.
Yeah, Glass scoring the last three UMass goals.
Puck knocked to the far sideline. Loose there. Notre Dame on it, left side. They've got it. Tim Kearney cuts to the front of the net. He's got some room to roam. Gives it off now for Gil Fillon. Brian Gil Fillon has it back now for Kearney. Notre Dame making some wholesale substitution as Pett and Sutton check back in. Pett's on it now. Gives it off for Sutton. They'll get their number one unit out there. Irish lead cut to one here. About 1 minute, 10 seconds left, third quarter.
Yeah, looking for some transition play, some slowdown play right here as they were doing early in the first half to take that early 2-0 lead.
Here's Kearney, marked by Jared Lanning, under a minute left in the period. Notre Dame up a goal, started this period down two. It's been an Irish third quarter. Off the move, James Keenan trying to move on Robbins. Now he's double teamed, two UMass players fall down. Sutton, open shot, goes just wide of the post. Willie Sutton had an open shot. Will remain ND ball.
Yeah, Notre Dame might have blown a big opportunity right there, as we did notice two UMass players down on the field. As we take a look at, head coach Kevin Corrigan for Notre Dame. You know, Notre Dame had the two-man advantage almost there as two Notre Dame players were on the field. They did miss the shot, though.
Yeah, a little angry at Sutton, perhaps, for missing that one wide. Here's Gil Fillon behind the UMass goal. Back to live action here. We've got 43 seconds. Gil Fillon trying to spin away from Drum. He'll stick it away from him nicely, and a steal. Harold Drum, his second steal in this quarter.
Yeah, beautiful play right there by the freshman, Harold Drum. He's really stepped it up this whole season, Anthony. He's just made some outstanding plays all throughout the season.
Lanning up for Waxer. He can't contain through midfield. Loose on the ground. Up for Valenti. He gets Glass right side. UMass has 20 seconds to get this thing tied up. Glass trying to make the move across the restraining line. Gets it there for Valenti. Back for Glass. Low shot. Saved by Alex Cade. And Cade back the other way for Sutton. They've got 10 seconds. Sutton across midfield.
Here they've got a 6-on-4, Anthony.
Willie Sutton for Colley. In front for Pett. He can't handle a pass. He had a great opportunity. And that will do it. At the end of three quarters, the score, Notre Dame 8, UMass 7.
Yeah, Notre Dame outscoring UMass 4-1 in that period, Anthony, as Glass had got the only UMass goal late with 13:09 in the third period.
We're going to step aside, 8-7, Notre Dame the score. We'll be back after these messages. And we're back, start of the fourth quarter, 8-7. Here we see Brendan Glass, his last goal opportunity for the Minutemen.
Yeah, as we said, he beat his defender, just pretty much walked in uncontested right there. A beautiful shot, but they need more. They only got one goal that period to Notre Dame's 4. You can't win if you don't score, Anthony.
8-7, Irish off the draw. Jay Robbins, UMass with a great chance here. Stick to side, Dennis Kelly has it. Pass down low, deflected away from Ken Sussey. He'll run to the corner. He's on it for the Minutemen. UMass with a good opportunity, winning faceoffs, no doubt crucial here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, exactly. You know, the first half it was even split right down the middle for faceoffs, but they really need to start picking it up.
Here's Glass on the move. His pass too wide for Valenti, but he'll touch up. Actually, he won't. Pass goes astray, and it will be Notre Dame ball in the turnover. Dangerous pass.
Yeah, I believe it was tipped off a UMass player right there, went out of bounds. Notre Dame does take over possession.
So here come the Irish back the other way with their one goal lead. Alex Cade, Tom Lopresti, the two goaltenders have really played a pretty solid game here this afternoon.
Yeah, they really have. That was one of the keys to the game. We had to have Lopresti really step it up, the fourth year starter. But the freshman Cade for Notre Dame has just put up some phenomenal numbers.
And there was a sloppy pass by number 30, James Keenan, over his intended man on the wing. Turnover for Notre Dame. So right back to the UMass end. The Minutemen will bring up another chance to get this thing tied. 30 seconds in here, fourth quarter. Irish up 8-7.
Yeah, UMass really needs to capitalize on any mistakes Notre Dame makes. Any mistake would come in handy. They really, like I said, they've just got to capitalize and score on this one.
Here's Lopresti up for Eric Bailey. He's going to try to move and cut to the front. Gets it off for Brendan Glass. He's been the star. 5 of the 7 UMass goals. Here's Valenti behind the net. Mike Valenti hounded there by Iorio. The matchup we've seen all day from Kevin Corrigan, the coach of Notre Dame. And here's Buddy Hoffman now, right side with it up top for Eric Bailey.
Yeah, the matchup's worked well for Notre Dame's favor as Valente's only got that one assist for today's game.
Here's Buddy Hoffman, we're moving up top. Takes a shot, goes just wide. Sussy will be there. The remain UMass ball. You talk about Valenti on the season. 7 goals, 15 assists for 22 points coming in just 7 games. Down off his usual scoring pace, just the one assist. And here's Brendan Glass back behind the goal. Trying to move on his defenseman. Glass around, harassed from behind there. Chris Burry on him. Gives it off for Bailey. Now back for Glass. Swings it far side for Valenti. Up for Hoffman. One-on-one move. Shot goes well high and wide. Will remain UMass ball. Buddy Hoffman missing that one. Wanted to shoot it high. That one's a good 5 feet up.
One thing I've noticed, Anthony, it looks like Mike Valenti is actually playing in front of the net this time. They're trying to move him around, put Ken Sussy right behind the net, try to get the point man in there, because if Valente's getting covered, it's more of a decoy. You pull him out, you get the big guy, Iorio, out of there, and then UMass can try to capitalize.
Sure, you'd very much like to get Iorio away from the front of that net. Here's Hoffman moving on his man, Todd Bialis. Gets it off now for Sussy back to Hoffman. So we see Sussy having replaced Jeremy Murphy effectively in effect in this latest set here. Up for Eric Bailey. Of course, Murphy out with a left hamstring pull. In front, shot by Hoffman goes just wide. A golden opportunity. Buddy Hoffman hit from behind on the ground looking for a call.
Yeah, he was looking for the call as he ended up with Iorio's stick. He does take a nice shot. It looked like Iorio did get his stick right into the face mask there. No call, though.
Behind the net, Sussy hit from behind, loses the ball, and stolen away there by Billy Gallagher. Gallagher to the corner, harassed by a couple of Minutemen, and gets it up for his teammate, Burry. And across midfield, here comes Notre Dame.
Yeah, Notre Dame's going to have to try to capitalize on this one as they are up 1 goal right now. Still no scoring in the fourth period yet. I'm sure they'd love to pad that lead, Anthony.
Mark Pasquale, left side, guarded there by Jim Kennedy of the Minutemen. Looking to move, get that padding goal, an insurance goal. As Pett rejoins the play, he'll get on it now. Number 33 for Notre Dame in the blue and gold. Pett making a move to the front, gives off for Pasquale. Kennedy on him. He'll reset that offense for the Irish. On the move, now he's double teamed, goes around them, shoots just wide of Lopresti, and we're going to get a call here. As Pasquale was on the move, making things happen.
Looks like possibly an interference on Jim Kennedy for Massachusetts. Looks like a 30-second EMO for Notre Dame. And as we talked about, I believe 2 for 2 in the game so far for Notre Dame.
The Notre Dame power play working very well. The extra man there, Jim Kennedy, indeed will sit in the box. A 1 minute slashing penalty on Jim Kennedy with 11:52 remaining here in the fourth.
As we take a look at that penalty, this is huge for UMass. They've really got to step it up right now, and they can't afford to give up another penalty.
Back behind, up top, right side for Gil Fillon. He's swinging around there. Mahoney on it, swings it for Colley, back down low. Shot score, Willie Sutton from a real sharp angle. Sutton gives ND a 2-goal lead. Extra man opportunity works again for the Fighting Irish.
Yeah, right there, as Willie Sutton just went in, you know, with the EMO, it's tough. You know, now they're 3-3 on the EMO. Sutton just came in, just beat Lopresti, you know, short side on the right.
I don't think Lopresti was expecting that at all. A real tough angle shot by Sutton. Lopresti may be looking for that centering pass, trying to cheat over a little bit to the center of the net and stop a pass, but Sutton ripped a shot off, and now Notre Dame has a 2-goal lead here. Their third goal with the extra man on Willie Sutton, his second goal of the game. He's got 19 on the season. And Colley gets the assist. He's his 17th on the season. Off the draw on their own end, Notre Dame has it. And it's Chris Burry. He'll get it across the timeline there for Todd Rassis. Running hard right side is Glenday. To the front of the net, goes just wide. Goes into the corner, and it will be Notre Dame ball.
Yeah, you know, the two-goal lead, there's still plenty of time left in this game, but Notre Dame is definitely jumping up and down. They've got the momentum on their side. UMass really needs to break this momentum and get the ball into the net.
So Notre Dame on it. Randy Colley behind the goal. Marked there by Greg McDonald of the Minutemen. Back behind for Gil Fillon, looking in front. They get it there for Jason Pett. He's on it. Notre Dame will take their time here. Two-goal lead. Going to make that three. Pasquale up top. Guarded by Kelly. Gets it over right side for Pett. UMass has Jim Kennedy out there with Kelly. Another flag is down. Penalty upcoming on the Minutemen.